All right, everybody, now we come to the last item in this series, and this is an item that I first saw 2 weeks before I bought it. The used tool store that I frequent, in his weekly video, he introduced this item that he had come in, and when I first saw it, I thought, ooh, that's nice. But then he proclaimed that the price that was going to be on it would be $125. So my initial thoughts were, you know, this is a screw thread micrometer, and the reality is that $125 for one of these is not that unreasonable, especially depending on what it had for anvils. Now, I only got a quick look at it in the video. So what ended up happening was I ended up going and I did some research, and then I looked and I ended up going there on opening day and asked to see the micrometer. And what I didn't like right off the bat was, well, it's got the foam cancer that is so prevalent in a lot of these old cases. I don't know what the heck the deal is, but this foam, when it ages, it starts to get dry and crumbly, and all of the little pieces come off and get into everything and make a mess. So that's the first problem, but you know, that's easy enough to solve. We just basically take this and throw it out and put a new piece of foam in there. Problem number two is that whoever had this micrometer at some point, or whatever company it came out of, engraved it, and that's clearly visible here, that somebody went through a lot of trouble with an engraver or a scraper or something, some tool, to grind the heck out of this in order to hide whatever that used to say right there. And then over here it says QC2, which would mean that this came out of quality control area number 2. Well, that's coming out, but you can see that damage there. So that's kind of a bummer. So that was kind of taking the shine off of this deal for me anyways. And the other thing that was taking the shine off of this deal was the fact that I already had a screw micrometer Mitutoyo that I had scored at a yard sale a while back and gotten a heck of a deal on. Matter of fact, I still have the tag on here. Mitutoyo thread mic, $25. Okay, and I bundled this with a bunch of other stuff that I ended up buying and getting a good deal on. So I got this one here for $25. Now, here's the thing, this is interesting. This is a number 126-137. This is a 226-137, and the reason why it's a 226 is because this is what's called a rolling micrometer. It's got this digital counter right here, which is kind of neat. Okay, so depending on how you feel about that type of a feature, that might be a big plus to somebody. But because of the damage on this, and because of the fact that I already had one, I wasn't really interested in paying the 125. So I figured, you know what, let's see what happens. I passed on. 2 weeks go by and I'm back there on a Wednesday because I spotted in the video a multi-draw cabinet, small cabinets, very similar to the 30-draw one that you guys may have seen in my shop before for hardware and stuff. And those cabinets, generally speaking, can trade anywhere from $50 to $100. There are even some people who ask more than that for him, but that's just getting crazy. Well, lo and behold, he had one there in the video for $30. And the reason why he had it for $30 was because it had a lot of the paint had come off, and wherever the paint was missing, it was rusted. So if you wanted to spend a little bit of time and some elbow grease, you know, sanding and painting it, you'd end up with a pretty nice piece. And if I didn't already have one, and if I wasn't getting so finicky in my old age, I probably would have snagged that thing. But I had to go there in person to see it, and I wanted to make sure I was the first one there. So I was number one in line when I got – actually, I was number two in line when I got there. And guess who was number one in line? I ended up talking to the guy, and guess what he came there for? He came there for the cabinet. But the funny thing is, when I said I had an interest in the cabinet, he actually wasn't that overly attached to it either. So he went in, looked at it, initially passed on it, passed it to me. I looked at it, thought about it, and then decided, you know what, I'm going to pass on it. But I alerted him to the fact that I was going to pass on it, which made him come back over and decide to take it. So I really kind of owe that guy a thanks that he was willing to basically forego it because I had come there for it. In the end, I ended up passing on it. So I was looking around, and I noticed that the thread micrometer was still there. And I said, geez, you know, like I said, he probably still has his price on here. He likes marking the price on these things. What's that god-awful pink? Here it is, $125, okay? I hate that stuff. Jesus. Anyways, I said, you know, you got room to move on this micrometer? And we went back and forth, and I ended up getting this micrometer for $70. I offered him 60, and we decided I think he wanted 80. Come down to 80. I said six. I was thinking 60. He said, "Why don't you split the difference with me?" And for $70, I got this micrometer, this thread micrometer. Now, why am I so happy about this? The $70. Well, because quite frankly, if this was empty right here, this would still be worth, even with this damage from the engraving, this would still be worth the $70 all day long. What I realized and what I even told him was, I said, I already got one of these. And the main reason I want this set is because I want to see whatever anvil tips that are in this set that are missing from my set. I'm going to take whatever ones I can use out of this set, put them in my set, and then I'm going to turn right around and sell this thing. And I'm going to probably make back my money and more and end up with a bunch of extra free anvils. Why is that significant? Well, price these anvils and you'll see why. It is unbelievable how expensive these little suckers are. So I am looking forward to actually being able to maybe score some out of here. So I should be able to find some out of this set to add to this set and make this a more complete set. So I'm going to take a few minutes to figure out what the heck I got going here. Well, all right, so I did a little bit of sorting here, and there was an anvil and a point and an anvil, I guess, in the micrometer itself. So I took those out, and they're clearly marked. The points are marked M with a dash C, and then the corresponding mating part is marked with a dash V. So for instance, you know, an M-1C you would use with an M-1V, I assume. They're supposed to be matched sets. For some reason, the two that I just took out of here, this is actually an M3, that's what it is, M3-C, but it was in there with a M6-V. And then all of these ones here I took out, they were all misplaced in the wrong holes. Turns out what I've got is I've got M1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6C, and then M1, 2, 3, 4, and 5V. This, that was in the mic, is the M6V. Okay, and then I've got an odd M1C, extra one. I'm sorry, M3C, I believe. But if I go back and I look at my original set that I purchased, I made sure that these are in the correct location. I actually have the M2 C and V, M3 C and V, M4 C and V, and M5 C and V. So what I'm going to be able to get out of this set is I'm going to be able to get the M6 and the M1. So I will have a complete set of points from M1 to M6. I'm just going to clean these up real quick because I can see on the magnification they've got some gunk on them. All right. So there's my keeper, because this micrometer is in excellent shape, even though it's not a rolling micrometer. And I've got my set complete M1 to M6 with matching anvils. As far as this goes, starters, I got to get rid of this foam. You can see, see how that's just awful how that's coming apart. And all of this little dust and stuff, it's sticking to all of the components in the box. So, clean that out. And oh, what do we got here? We got some goodies. Well, they may have removed his initials, but they forgot. They left Norm's tool order in here. It's like he ordered on October 27th, 86. He ordered a 0 to 1 inch pitch micrometer, interchangeable pitch. Oh, nice. What do we got? We got the original paperwork here. That's an extra bonus. I didn't even know it was in there. Okay, well, here's a, what's this, a little commercial for a Mitutoyo digital readout? Or did this end up getting in here by mistake? Digital readout unit for machine tools. Linear scale. Alright. That doesn't belong in there. Certificate of accuracy from Mitutoyo. And this is a use and care sheet for use and care of outside micrometer. I think that's just maybe a generic one they pack with all outside micrometers, no matter what type they are. Ah, here we go. And here is the digit outside micrometer, series 193. It's interesting. That's actually also not for this. This has got this, the way you can tell these from what I gather is that the regular ones look like this, the anvil's solid, and on these you have this this part right here that I think locks in that piece when you put it in there. Not positive. So I'm gonna take all this decrepitated foam out of here and clean this out. So it's interesting to me that Mitutoyo uses two different types of foam here. They use that thin, soft foam sheet goes in the bottom here, and then they use this stiffer foam to actually keep the micrometer captive from being able to move around. And whatever this foam is, it doesn't appear to deteriorate. It doesn't appear to be subjected to the same kind of deterioration over time that the other foam is. This is actually in pretty good shape. So I've cleaned this out, so now what I can do is if I can find a thin piece of foam to lay in the bottom here, put this in there, and then another piece for the top, I can actually get this back to a point where it's nice and protected, but isn't getting completely filthy from that stuff. All right, I looked around, and I found this foam, and it's the right type of foam, and it's the right color. The only problem is, it's thick. This is actually from a shipping cart for a hard drive. I had saved it, because I save a lot of packing material for when I need to ship things. So, my problem is, I gotta cut this. I wanna cut it so that it's about as thick as this. So, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to cut this, but I have an idea how I might be able to get away with doing this. I got this serrated edge knife for cutting bread in my kitchen. Don't tell the missus, she wouldn't approve. Yeah, it's a little too thick. Shaving that down is going to be tricky. Oh, How thick is the piece on the bottom supposed to be? Oh, it's a thin piece. Never be able to get that made that way. I'm going to find something else for that, I guess. Either that or I can just leave it out, I guess. This fits in here pretty tight. Alright, this was too long, I think, right? Bad side. There we go. That look better? Yeah, this box has got some issues. This will click closed if we didn't have too thick of a piece in there. Alright, so that was a failed experiment. Just for the heck of it. See if I take the one from my other box and put it in there. Just curiosity. Yep, perfect. What I need a sheet of gray foam that thickness. I wonder if I can get that kind of stuff at one of those craft stores. Alright, two layers should do it for the bottom piece. That was much thinner. Alright, fold it over two pieces. So it's four layers thick. That seems to be a good thickness. I just got some two-sided tape I'm going to use to keep this down. This two-sided tape is handy stuff, but it's a pain to deal with getting the two sides exposed. One side comes right off because it peels off the roll. It's that other paper that comes, makes it a little tough to get off. Putting it in between the layers and making a sandwich. Don't gotta get too fancy with it. Just want it so that when you flip it open, it's not falling out of there. And the box is deformed, which doesn't help. But at least when you close it, it doesn't rattle. So that'll work. So all I got to do now is decide whether or not I want to list this for sale with no points, or do I want to include all of these points that I have as extras, or should I list the sets of points independently in case somebody wants to buy those, because since they're, I think Mitutoyo, I think these are like $30 a pair or something like that. Which is kind of nuts. Not even sure if there's a market for the used ones. Well, guys, get a load of this. Apparently, this is a 226 series micrometer, and apparently these little plastic side pieces, of which I have one that's all torn up with somebody's initials being ground off of it, are available as a separate replacement part. I wonder if you could still get those.
I really hate this stuff that he uses to write the price on all of his tools, because it's pretty rugged stuff. It doesn't wipe off easily. And I'm always worried, you know, he puts it on a surface like this, that whatever you use to take it off is going to be strong enough to possibly damage the painted surface below it. So I've been trying to find out what the heck to do about making a decision on this. I decided I'm just going to list this with these anvils, because this seems to be, it's pretty confusing. I am able to find this exact thread micrometer with anvils for sale on various places on the internet, none of which appear to be eBay. eBay has several micrometers like this, but with a different part number, and they're all 0 to 25 millimeter, whereas this is a 0 to 1 inch. Even the current Mitutoyo catalog doesn't show this. That doesn't mean anything. That just means that this is no longer current. See how hard that is to get that off? That's ridiculous. Why the heck? I'm sure he's worried that it's going to wipe off and people are going to go up there and try and buy something for less than what he marked it for. But I'll see. Previously, this has worked pretty well to get this off. Today, it's being a lot more stubborn. Nuts, I tell you.
All right, I think that's going to conclude this episode. And we'll send this up to the chopping block. You know, it's interesting, these points right here, they appear to all be for metric threads. So I'm thinking maybe these holes down here would have been for all of your standard threads, which means that not only did this one not have any points for that, neither did the other one that I have. So this one now apparently has a full set to do all metric threads, which is interesting because it's a 0 to 1 inch micrometer, not a 0 to 25 millimeter or something like that. I don't know. So I may never ever see these points. So that would make this, I guess, not really useful to me. Well, it was still a nice score. It's just something that probably would be more popular overseas. Hold the phone, stop the presses. I've got an announcement to make. It's actually the following day, but I'm gonna drop this video clip in somewhere in the middle of this video because I've got some information that I just wanted to make sure I got out right away pertaining to this whole deal here with these anvils. Because I did a little bit of research, and then finally, when I couldn't get the answers I wanted off of the internet, I actually called Mitutoyo customer service, talked to the technical assistance department, spoke to a gentleman there, and he was quite helpful with my noob questions. So, but first, I'm pleased to announce that I listed this just last night after making this video. I listed this on eBay with a buy it now of $125, and when I woke up this morning, I got a notification that it had already been sold. I'm still awaiting payment, but I have no reason to believe that this individual isn't going to pay, because I don't ship it until it's paid. So anyways, it looks like that $125 for this with the four anvil sets there must have been a pretty good deal, because that guy jumped right on it. All right, so far so good. But let me talk about these anvils. So what was bothering me about these thread micrometer sets, both of the ones that I own, was the fact that all of these anvils up here begin with an M prefix, which made me think metric. And actually, that's partly true. And then what also bothered me was I noticed that in both of the sets I had, and all of the sets that I noticed for sale on eBay used, that none of those sets seem to have any of the anvil sets down here below this line that has a prefix of W. So at one point I actually thought, believe it or not, I actually figured that W might mean Whitworth, and that these might be for Whitworth threads. And after speaking with technical assistance today, lo and behold, yes indeed, that's exactly what this is for. These down here, these anvils from here to here, are for Whitworth threads. Whitworth threads, I believe, have a 55 degree angle. Metric threads up here have a 60 degree angle. 60 degree is also the same angle as unified thread. So, these M prefix ones up here are what are needed for metric and also for unified thread. And if I had not been such a noob, I would have probably been able to deduce this by the fact that right here, there is a U in parentheses next to this row of numbers, and there is an M in parentheses next to this row of numbers. And essentially what they're telling you is they're telling you that, for instance, the M1-C here anvil set is actually for either unified thread 48 to 64 TPI or metric thread. Okay, so what this means is that, for instance, now because I took the M1 and the M6 out of this set and made my other set complete, what this means is that now this set with M1 through M6 is complete, and I can use it to measure threads anywhere from 3.5 to 64 threads per inch, provided, of course, that the major diameter is not more than 1 inch, because this is a 0 to 1 inch micrometer. And if I wanted to measure metric threads, basically you would use the same exact anvil set, only preferably you would want this micrometer to be a metric micrometer, so you could do a direct reading. Now, technically, I think I should be able to do metric threads by simply using these anvils in this micrometer and converting whatever I get for a decimal reading to metric. A little extra step there. But that, you know, straightens things out for me. It gets things right in my head as far as wrapping my head around how this works. Then I asked about, I said, gee, I couldn't find these Whitworth threads anywhere, anvils for the Whitworth threads anywhere online. I said, are they no longer available? And he checked and he said, oh, no, no. As a matter of fact, there's a part number for a complete set, and then there's a part number for just the individual anvils. By the way, you remember I talked about how expensive these anvils were? These anvils, one pair of anvils, new, runs anywhere from $70 to $90, depending on where you buy them. But that's the going retail price on these, is $70 to $90 a piece. So that other set that I just sold has four pairs, because you can buy this micrometer without any anvils and then buy the anvils separately, or you can buy, in the MSC catalog, for instance, you can buy just the anvil, I mean, just the micrometer with no anvils, or you can buy the micrometer with a set of anvils, and they're darn expensive. But it turns out, yeah, the Whitworth ones are available. He gave me the Mitutoyo part numbers, which are the classic Mitutoyo six-digit, three-digit part numbers. And I was able to Google that, and sure enough, I was able to find quite a few different sources for Whitworth, Whitworth thread anvils. So I don't need to deal with Whitworth thread. I think very few American manufacturers or machine shops need to deal with this, and that's probably why it's not something you find in like the MSC catalog or most of the major vendors that most machine shops tend to frequent, don't tend to carry these. But you can get these still if you needed them. So to sum up, I'm very pleased with A, that I've got now I've got a thread micrometer that's fully functional for quite a few different applications, but my prediction is I still bet that I hardly ever use this. And then the other thing that I'm pleased to report is the fact that this has sold. When you sell something on eBay with a buy it now and it sells right away, it's kind of it's a double-edged sword, or kind of a mixed bag of feelings. Part of me is thinking, wow, hey, that's great. I didn't have to wait. I already sold it. But the other part of me can't help but thinking, boy, should I maybe price it a little bit higher? Especially considering that I put this down for $125 or best offer. I had the best offer feature enabled. So the fact that this individual didn't even bother putting in an offer lower to see if I would take it, he immediately jumped on it. Now, that was actually, if he really needed this micrometer, which I'm assuming he did, that's actually a wise move, because since I did price it below market value, by jumping on it and paying the $125, he guaranteed that he actually is the one who won the item. As opposed to if he had put in an offer of, say, $100, if while he was waiting for me to get back to him to let him know if I was going to accept the $100, if somebody else came along and saw it and said, well, geez, you know, that's a really good deal, I'm just going to pay to buy it now, they could swoop in and actually get it. So if you put an offer in on an item that's, you know, below the full offer, that doesn't guarantee that you don't hold that. It's not like that item's going to be held for you until you make a decision. So actually, I just received notification through my eBay app on my phone, because since I had not received payment yet, okay, I asked him whether or not he wanted to pick it up, because he's actually local to me. He's only, well, he's in Massachusetts. Nope, okay, he's just letting me know that he did get my message, and he's just going to have me ship it. And, oh, that cash register dinging noise you just heard, that is my notification that he has just paid through PayPal. Okay, great. I'm not sure where this is going to be dropped into this video, so either we're going to go back to my ramblings from last night, or we're going to close it out right here. I don't know. Well, hope you guys enjoyed seeing my finds, you know, my flea market finds. And please remember, if you like watching this kind of stuff, click the subscribe button. This box is really misshapen. There you go, now it's closed. It's probably not closing too well because of my makeshift foams inserts. Oh well. Take care.